Hello friends, welcome to this video on number system. In the previous video, we learned about rational and irrational numbers. In this session, we will learn about decimal expansion of rational and irrational numbers. Friends, can you identify the rational and irrational numbers from these numbers? We can easily identify them by simply taking note of the definition. So these are rational numbers and these are irrational numbers. All given rational numbers are in the form of fractions. Can we write them in decimal form? Yes. For that, we will have to solve them by the division method. Let's take the first example, 5 by 4. Here, we will divide 5 by 4. We get the answer as 1.25. In this example, after a few steps, the remainder becomes 0 and the decimal expansion in the quotient ends. Therefore, this decimal expansion is called terminating decimal. Now let's take the next example, 10 by 9. Here, when 10 is divided by 9, the remainder 1 is repeating instead of getting a 0. Similarly, in the quotient also, 1 is repeating and its decimal expansion is continuing in form of 1.1111. If you observe it carefully, it is a never-ending process. A decimal expansion where both the remainder and the quotient are repetitive is called non-terminating or recurring decimal expansion. We can also write it as 1.1. The bar above reveals the group of digits that recur. If we look at the third example, 1 by 27. Here too, the remainder is not zero. If we look at this division carefully, after the third step, we are getting the same remainder again. If we solve this further, then the same three steps are being repeated. And now if we look at the quotient, then we realize that just like there is repetition in the remainder, there is a repetition of 037 group of digits in the quotient after the decimal point. So can we call this decimal expansion also non-terminating or recurring? Yes, and we will write it as 0.037 bar. Friends, can you tell what is the difference between examples 2 and 3? In example 2, only one number is repeating. But in example 3, a group of digits are repeating. If we compare all three examples, we can say that in the decimal expansion of rational numbers, after a few steps, the remainder either becomes zero or starts repeating itself. The numbers in the remainder are always less than the divisor. Like in example 2, 1 is getting repeated and the divisor is 9. In case of example 3, there are 3 blocks of repetition and the divisor is 27. Friends, so far we have seen the decimal expansion of rational numbers. Can we write irrational numbers also like this? See. The decimal expansion of root 2 and root 5 is as follows. If you look at them carefully, the numbers are neither being repeated here nor are they ending. Likewise, we can find many irrational numbers and write their decimal expansion. You must be familiar with pi. Its decimal expansion is also like this. Here also, the numbers are neither getting repeated nor are they ending. Thus, we can conclude that the decimal expansion of irrational numbers is non-terminating, non-recurring. Friends, can you write an irrational number like this? Yes, we can write many such numbers. Friends, that's all in this video. In this session, we learnt about the decimal expansion of rational and irrational numbers. See you in the next video. Thank you.